everyone. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another Sims 4 build video. So today I'm going to be doing a house tour of a house that I've built recently called Caribbean Dream. This is a 3-bedroom, 3-bathroom house, and it is currently available for download on the Sims 4 gallery. It does use quite a few packs, which I apologize for. It's not really base game friendly, but I think you guys will enjoy it. So this is the outside of the house. You kind of got a quick overview of it in the intro. So let's just go ahead and head on inside. I don't know. I'm really into doing like these tropical, like Caribbean jungly kinds of builds right now. I really want to go on vacation and that's what I think of. So we have a beautiful front porch area. Over here I set up the games table for playing cards or Don't Wake the Llama, just because I thought it would be a nice thing to do outside on the front porch. And then inside we have this beautiful open floor plan. Over here is the kitchen area. I used a lot of blue and white in this house primarily. I wanted it to try to feel as cool as possible, and I don't know, those colors always feel very cooling to me. Nice open kitchen area. Over here there's a dining area with a big round table, perfect for family gatherings, and of course a ceiling fan because it's hot in the tropics. And then over here we have the first bathroom that you'll come to. This bathroom has like this funky tealy blue green tile, and then the shower and the sink are both actually from City Living, and then the flooring is bowling night stuff, but it's all like the same bluey green color scheme. So normally for the first floor I wouldn't do a full like with shower bathroom, but because I have no shower in one of the bathrooms upstairs, I just have a tub, I wanted to put a shower in down here. And then this room should look pretty familiar if you watched last week's video. This is like the sunroom slash living room area. I rebuilt this room on a slightly larger scale for last week's video because while I was building this house, I had a lot of builder's block actually. But this room I like fell in love with right away. It is so light and airy. I love these windows from Cats and Dogs because they don't have any window panes in them, so it's really nice to get this like kind of cross breeze effect, I think. So then through here we'll go out to the backyard. Around this way is just a trash can around the corner. I'm not gonna bother showing you that. And then down here we have our pool. So this is the pool area. There's a diving platform. There's a nice fountain over here with some landscaping. There's some lily pads with flowers. And then over here we have another big round table, perfect for family meals, and a cute little grill. This grill I think came from the toddler stuff pack. And then of course lots of plants and flowers from the Jungle Adventure pack. So once again, this is another tropical build that uses a lot from Jungle Adventure. But the items from that pack just work really well for this like tropical theme. So that's kind of what I have to go with. So upstairs here, we have this nice little landing area, again with the blue and white, but this time with like little pops of yellow. And then in here to the right is the first bedroom that we'll come to. This is a kid's room. Again, blue and white color scheme of the house. But it's kind of got like a cloud and sky motif, because I always think that this bedding looks like clouds. I don't know if it's actually supposed to be clouds or not, but it sort of looks like clouds. And then we got like the stars from the holiday free stuff pack, I guess you would say. And I always like to put a little, I don't know, not always, but sometimes I like to put a little frog on a kid's table in their bedroom because it's sort of like their little pet, even though it's not actually a pet. So this is the kid's room. Pretty nice, I think. And then next door we have the master suite. Have you ever looked at a bed in The Sims and thought, I would lay on that bed? And that's kind of how I feel about this bed. I don't know, maybe I'm just tired. Again, lots of blue and white. I tried to use like lots of furniture that was more like traditional or wooden in appearance in here. And then through here we have the master bathroom with like this funky blue tile, but I kind of love it. It's very fitting, I think. And then of course this is the bathroom that does not have a shower. It just has a bathtub because, I don't know, I almost never use just the standalone bathtubs because for gameplay purposes, like, it just makes more sense to have a shower. But since there's a shower downstairs, I went with it. And then this bedroom is actually technically set up as an office, but it could also be a kid's bedroom or just another bedroom in general. I originally was going to decorate this as a kid's bedroom, but I just couldn't bring myself to do it. This was part of the builder's block. So I set it up as an office instead. And this way, you know, personally, I always like having a computer behind a locked door, so that way then if your sim has guests come over, they don't get onto your computer because you can just lock the door. And then over here we have the last bathroom of the house, again using lots of stuff from Jungle Adventure, like this crazy tile. Tried to tone it down as much as I possibly could, but again, kind of leaning into that whole like jungle, tropical, Caribbean kind of vibe here. So I believe this house is like 89,000 simoleons if you download it. But yeah, so again, no custom content anywhere. Probably a good idea to turn on move objects before you place this house, although nothing too catastrophic will happen if you don't. And yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you liked it, you can give it a thumbs up and you can subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I put up a new video every Tuesday, so thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye!